This is Bubbles doing an interview with Remarc for raveguide.co.uk. So let's start with where you've been for the last 10 years.
Well, I've been about still, you know what I mean? I've been playing out still, I've been DJing certain things and that still. Really what happened about 95, 96, started to go off the scene a bit, like all changed, like all the jungle thing started disappearing and that. Just kind of basically went off it. Been following it all the way through, still been there in the background, lingering, waiting for a time to come back, so to speak, which is now to me.
Why did you go off it?
It just started going a different way to what I was into, and I feel a lot of other people was into. Started getting all bouncy. That's when I went off of it. It started going all bouncy and I just weren't in it. And then as it went on, it started to get more techno-y. And like, I don't know, say 2 years ago, I was going out and I was just not in it at all, even still then. Just too techno-y, too kind of hard. And it's like people, to me, it felt like people was forgetting that they're making tunes. It was like they were just trying to like buy a new piece of equipment, work it to its most fullest, getting all these hard sounds out of it and all that. Just not into it, man. I'm more about the bass and the drums. You know what I mean? Which, I mean, the bass in it now, it's all like mid-bass kind of thing. Yeah. Even that, I mean, that's what I'm saying, my future productions. I'm gonna have some proper beelines in it, you know what I mean? I mean, it's good still as it is.
What's your opinion on the scene today?
Personally, I think it's crying out for musically, it's crying out for some kind of change right now. It's, you know, to me personally, it's kind of monotonous, repetitive. You know, it's crying for some type of, I mean, like Shy's murderation thing now. You know what I mean? It's got the same, it's got the flow of the new school thing, it's got the singing, it's something different, and you know, it's blown up. Just, that's what it's crying for. Something else needs to happen to it right now, I think.
And that's where you come in.
Something like that, yeah.
And when you're making tunes, where did you get your inspirations from? Back in the day and now?
Back in the day, I've always been into rag, I've always been into hip hop. I mean, so that's where most of my inspirations always come from. It's still the same. The things I'm working on now, still, after, you know, the stuff that I've got coming, there's ragga in it still. I'm doing a remix for Kemet at the moment. Same, like, ragga vocal things. That's, yeah.
And is there anyone that you look up to back in the day?
Back in the day? Do you know, I wouldn't say I actually look up to anyone, you know, but I've got enough respect for probably everybody that's involved in the scene, you know what I mean? Everyone, I mean, you take Hype, I've got enough respect for him, maybe because, you know, back in the day before I'd done anything, I remember listening to Hype on Fantasy, you know what I mean? So I used to look up to him, I suppose, but, you know, everybody, all the big name DJs, the new up-and-coming guys and that. I got respect for all of them. They kept the scene going, you know what I mean? I mean, producer-wise, you know, they've gone from that scene as it was, like the jungle scene, come through all these changes, and they're still in it now. You know, something maybe that I couldn't do, because I couldn't make them kind of change, probably because I was just not feeling them. Mm. You know, but they've adapted and gone through. So, yeah, man, I got respect for everybody that's part of the scene, man.
And what other types of music do you listen to?
Ragga and hip hop mainly.
Okay. So you make any other styles of music?
Nah. Do you know what? I like this question because I like to set something straight. There's a little thing that I kept reading about places and all things like that. Remarc makes garage, nah, blah, blah. I made one garage track. That was it. For them pure garage compilations, and then we ended up putting it out as a single because it done well. But that is it. So let it be clear and known to everyone. Remarc, not into garage, man.
You had a brief stint with Breakbeat, though. Tell us about that.
Breakbeat. That's what I mean. All these stories, aren't Breakbeat what? Yeah, I mean, I made jungle tunes. I mean, I come from hardcore. I made jungle. I mean, drum and bass and that. I just, you know, I was going out to garage for a while. Like I say, I went off to the jungle scene, drum and bass stuff. Wasn't in it. Started going out with the garage team, made one garage track. And that's it. That's as far as Remarc and breakbeat and garage and all them kind of thing goes, mate. I mean, I've been into drum and bass still, going out and everything into it. I've just not been producing. You know, the only DJing I've been doing is like old school stuff all the way through. I still DJ old school stuff. But there is no Remarc breakbeat man or Remarc garage veteran, nothing like that, man. So I hope we cleared that up.
Okay. And where do you see the DMB scene in the future? Where do you think it will be in 5 years' time?
One thing for sure, it's definitely going to be here still, and it's definitely going to keep getting stronger and stronger. You know what I mean? I mean, I've been roundabout in the scene for 10 years plus now, and you see the generations coming and going. You know what I mean? And when I go out now, it's just a completely new generation. In those generations, you get the DJs, you get the MCs, or the wannabe DJs and MCs that will get there eventually. You know, so they're the ones that's going to be running it in 5 years.
And what do you think about these days, the MCs being bigger than the DJs, like they're the stars, having their own conventions and stuff?
I think a lot of that comes down to the music and the producing of it all. There's hardly any samples in anything anymore. The music's made for MCs, really. The MCs are there in the limelight, they're front of the stage, they're hyping the crowd up. Of course they're going to be main thing now. But the MCs is nothing without the DJ. Yeah. But, I mean, back in the day, it would have been more important, you know, but now the DJ is nothing without the MC as well. So they both need each other, so. But I think it's good for them, man.
Okay. And when you're making tunes, what programs do you use?
Cubase. I've always used Cubase. Right now I'm using Cubase SX.
Always?
Not always, I've changed to that recently. I know everyone, or a lot of people, use Logic now and Reason, but I played with Reason. Logic I've touched about, and I don't like Reason. Cubase is for me. So I use.
And who's your favourite DJ?
I always say Swift, man. I don't know.
Why?
Just I've heard nearly every DJ out there. I don't care who they are. I've heard everyone clang, at least once, twice. I've never yet heard Swift clang. Maybe he has, but I've just not been there or heard it, but of course he has, he must have done, but Swift. Still waiting for my promos, man.
And who's your favourite MC? And you're not allowed to say X-Man.
That's hard because, do you know what? Everybody's like, of course it's going to be X-Man, but it is. When I see him working, I see him working by the side of, you know, by the side of everyone. Navigator, Fearless, everyone. And from what I see and I watch him, he can roll with anyone. He can roll with anyone. I'm not saying that he's better than anyone or nothing, but he can just roll with them and keep up the pace, change his style to work with theirs, bounce off them and whatnot. You know, I see some, you know, you see some MCs working together and you can see it's just a big change of style and whatnot. But, I mean, so I've got that piece out of the way. Fearless, always big up Fearless because as far as I see it, back in the day, like when we was on Rush and all that, Fearless was the only one busting lyrics them days. Everybody else just used to talk and whatnot, and at the raise it was like a crowd hyping thing. Fearless was one of the first ones, if not the first one, to be busting lyrics over like hardcore or whatever it was then. So Fearless, X-Man.
Okay. X-Man. And what projects have you been working on? You've got something coming out?
I just released, well, a little while ago, released the album of all like my bigger tunes from back in the jungle era. Got a second album coming out of like, I mean, that one done so well. It's like, I didn't think it was going to be that well. It's done as many as like some of the bigger drum and bass tunes now and whatnot. So I'm doing a second one with all my unreleased dub plates, which is on a label called Planet Mew, which is nothing to do with drum and bass, but guys are all into breaks and stuff. So that's coming out to be released in about March. I've just about finished a remix for Kemet. I'm not sure when they're going to be releasing that. And me and X are in the studio planning on our new label for next year, playing around and whatnot, so watch out for that.
Well, thank you very much.
Thank you very much.